In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, we are celebrating the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time, Year A. And our readings are taken from the book of Ezekiel and the letter of St. Paul to the Romans and the Gospel of Matthew, specifically from Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 7 to 9, Romans chapter 13, verse 8 to 10, and the Gospel from Matthew chapter 18, verse 15 to 20. And the theme that comes clearly from these three readings is all about fraternal correction, fraternal love, fraternal care. But I would like us to meditate specifically on the theme, the real love for a brother or for a neighbor or for a sister. The real love for a neighbor. We take it that way. We know that when we love someone, we offer them good things. When we love someone, we visit them. When we love someone, we care for them. When we love someone, we open our heart to them. When we love someone, we also receive the love they offer to us. That's what is very common to each and every one of us. And all this calls our attention on the other side of love. Love means being truthful to other people, to those we love, being honest to them, being transparent to them. And that's why we see that it's connecting us to the what we call and what is underlined in the readings of today, fraternal correction. And that's why we see in the first reading that is taken from Ezekiel chapter 33, verse 7 to 9. The theme that is underlined clearly is that the Lord is severe regarding correcting others. And he underlined that when we refuse to fulfill our duties, our responsibilities towards our brothers, towards our sisters, in correcting them, we are the sinners. So that means that we allow them to fall in sin, God will end up punishing us ourselves. And that's how also we see he's trying also to show us that if we love someone, we should open ourselves to help them to grow in faith. We should tell them what their wrongdoings, not only their good doings. So we see also from there that it is all about the obligations that all of us we have, and especially those who have dependents. For example, the parents, the educators, the superiors, and also the pastors, towards the faithful. Each and everyone has the responsibility to tell the truth to those they are in charge of, those they care for. It's very important. And that's why when we move in from there also, we see that in the second reading, St. Paul underlines something very important, that we have the depths of mutual love that we owe to our neighbor. And he underlines that because of the fraternal correction. If we have the depths of love, of mutual love towards our brothers and our sisters, which is about correction, we should be honest to them. And then we see that Jesus also underlines it. How should we approach fraternal correction? How should we help our brothers to change and correct their wrongdoings without feeling bad? Jesus has left four steps for each and every one of us. And the four steps are really connected. And when we follow them, the logic in them is that it will work. Except some of us who have very hard hearts, who are not open to learn. The first step is, if your brother sins, go and see him or her alone. Your brother alone or your sister alone. If they don't listen to you, second step, take them in front of two or three people. And if they don't listen again, the third step comes. So you take them to the community. If they don't listen again, you get away from them. And when Jesus is talking about getting away from them, he does not mean that we separate ourselves from them, we hate them, we remove them from our paths, from our lives. Jesus wants to tell us that we try now to split or separate between the sinner and the sin. We love the sinner, we hate his sins. We don't take his proposals of life. We don't follow his ways of doing things, but we continue keeping them in our hearts, in the sense that we keep them in our hearts, we pray for them, we care for them. We don't remove them from our life, for if we do so, now we don't help them to grow. And it's very important also to see that in the first reading, when the prophet emphasized on God's being savior regarding other correction, we see that it's connected to the gospel. How do we correct other people? These are two sides of the same coin. Because if you love your brother, you should help them to grow. You should correct them. You should not let them also to be fallen into sins here and there. And it means that we have the responsibility to help others to know their faults and to correct them. It's like, for example, someone who is in the car. When you drive the car in the village, in the remote area, you shake dust on those who are walking, the pedestrian, and then you don't know that the dust disturbs them until they stop you and inform you, my friends, when you arrive here, you shake a lot of dust. Or until you yourself, one day you are walking and then someone shakes also the dust with his car, then you feel how others used to feel. So it's upon each and every one of us that we know that we have not to fear. We have not to fear, but we should approach our brothers and sisters with that love. Because most of the times, parents or educators or teachers or pastors fear to tell the truth to other people, to those they are in charge of, for the fear that they will be rejected, they will lose their popularity, or they will not receive in return the love they want from the other people. And this should not be the case. We should be open to help other people to know their wrongdoings, and also in order to avoid being admonished by the Lord. Because in the first reading, it's very clear. If we fail to fulfill our responsibility, we will be admonished. And the other thing also very important is that we should not judge other people. We should not judge them. Each and every one of us has his or her failures. We should not judge them. The other option there Jesus gives us is to know that we should be ready to forgive other people, because the Paternoster, the prayer of our Lord, says it clearly, forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And it's very important. And also the other aspect of that is that we should pray for those who sin against us, or we should pray for those who see the sin against other people and they are not ready to change, instead of judging them. We should also be open to be corrected most of the time. For example, information what I have seen is that many people end up losing their vocation because of rigidity of heart. They are not open to learn. They think they know everything. And with that, we don't grow. We don't grow. Let us invoke the Holy Spirit to guide us, to open our heart in order to be ready to learn from others, in order to be able to open ourselves, to be honest, transparent, to correct other people and help them to grow in faith. And may Almighty God grant us the grace that we need in order to be humble enough to learn from other people, to be humble and honest enough to correct other people and help them and follow in the steps that Jesus has left for us. And may Almighty God bless you to witness this gospel value by your lives, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.